I sincerely believe that infectious diseases are a great threat to national security because we have emergence of new diseases with increased travel and globalization. We have an increase in antimicrobial resistance. But for being effectively able to respond to all of these, whether it's in some remote village in Africa or a clinic here in the United States or our troops that may be deployed in remote areas of the world, we need to be able to have diagnostics that provide the answers then and there and are indiscriminate and able to tackle any disease at any given point of time. The basic premise that our team works on is the understanding that our innate immune system, is capable of recognizing all pathogens, whether it's bacterial or viral, whether it's natural or engineered, drug resistant or not. And it does this by recognizing patterns of the pathogens that might be present in our body. So our immune system is a universal biosensor. And so we feel that if we are able to mimic this immune recognition in the laboratory, we could have a universal strategy for the early diagnosis of all infection. We started working, trying to develop diagnostics for tuberculosis, which is very difficult to discriminate between exposure and infection. During active infection with tuberculosis, the pathogen actually secretes these molecules that are present in the body, and our first attempt was to try to develop diagnostics that target this pathogen. In trying to do that, we realized some unique features about the host, the human body, and its interaction with the pathogen, and a common mechanism by which this recognition happens and is utilized by our innate immune system. And this led us to conceive the notion that this approach could actually be used not just for TB, but adapted to all pathogens. So essentially tailoring the assays so they will work for all of these pathogens so we can apply it indiscriminately without any prior knowledge of what that person might be sick with is the huge challenge that we're dealing with right now. So having simple solutions could change the quality of life for so many people across the world. This is something that a place like Los Alamos can most effectively respond to, because a problem of developing a point of care diagnostics for infectious disease writ large is not just a problem in biology, it's not just a problem in microbiology. It's a problem that requires working at the intersection of engineering and chemistry and optics and physics and computational abilities in addition to microbiology and understanding of human biology, so that the solution actually has a real world application. And that is why Los Alamos National Laboratory is committed to try to make this real and be able to deploy this for everybody to be able to use it in the future.